improvements to the forecast modeling, organizations can now configure forecasts to support many more complex requirements, including custom entities for rollups and hierarchies for common sales scenarios, and multicurrency support for worldwide teams. These enhancements will allow sellers to quickly access their most recent forecasts while benefiting from a refreshed user interface and customizations. The first improvement we'll look at includes custom entity support for forecast rollup and forecast hierarchy entities through a new option to create a forecast from scratch. After naming your custom forecast, from the rollup entity, you can select any entity that contains the amount value that powers the forecast. In this example, we'll use opportunity product with product as the hierarchy entity. Next, we'll select a relationship and top of hierarchy value, which will generate a preview. From here, we can go through the normal steps to complete the forecast. When we look at the completed forecast, you'll see it is showing the product that we had selected. When we go to the underlying records, they are shown at the opportunity product level, since that's what the forecast was built on. We can also gain insights on what opportunities are contributing to this forecast by simply grouping the underlying records by opportunity and drilling down further into each. The second enhancement provides the ability to break down the forecast by a specific dimension, for example, by product, product family, or by account. Let's start with the user experience. Here, you'll notice a new drill down option in the upper left, which allows you to view all the drill downs that have been configured. If we select account, for example, the icons next to each entity turn blue, which allows us to view the forecast of an individual and to see how well they've been penetrating each account. Alternatively, we can select to view the forecast by product family by changing the drill down option to parent product, which lets us view what products an individual has been selling into more than others. From the admin side, we also have a new step for drill down, which provides the option to either use a template or to create a drill down from scratch. There are multiple ways to configure a drill down. A simple method is to configure the drill down by option set instead of by entity. In this example, we've selected budget in order to see how the forecast budget is being distributed. The third feature adds support for quantity-based columns, allowing organizations to assess the actual number of products forecasted to be sold, in addition to the total revenue expected. For example, let's look at a product-based forecast and how to configure the columns to be quantity-based. First, we need to go into the best case category and enter best case quantity, with the data type set to decimal and amount field set to quantity. When we save and go back to best case revenue, you'll notice that the data type is now currency and the amount field is the extended currency amount. Now, if we view the forecast from the user experience, we can see columns for both a quantity forecast and a revenue-based forecast. Calculated columns within a forecast can also now be adjusted. Previously, this required adding a new column for forecasted commitments, which would add 1 plus committed. It was not possible to make an adjustment from a roll-up column to a calculated column like committed forecast. Now we have this ability to allow for adjustments. When setting up a calculated column, simply enter your values, check the Allow Adjustments option, and save. When we refresh, we can see the committed forecast allows for fields to be adjusted. The final enhancements add several new advanced admin capabilities. The first of these is the ability to auto-hide the manager from their own forecast when there is no quota value, for instances when a manager is not working on any opportunities. Additionally, multicurrency selection has been added to make the forecast data viewable in any system available currency, which converts currency in real time. For example, you'll see here that Dustin's parent row is auto-hid and not displayed under his own forecast because he is not assigned a quota. as compared to Samuel, who does have open opportunities and appears accordingly. You'll also see in the top right there is a drop-down menu allowing the user to change the currency of the forecast. Returning to the advanced admin capabilities, we now also have the ability to control the editability of particular columns by adding a JavaScript library. Once the library has been uploaded as a web resource, it will be available within the list to be added. Now, if we go to the forecast and click on a record, you'll see that any fields made uneditable through the JavaScript command are no longer able to be changed. In contrast, if we look at a different record that these commands were not applied for, you can see the fields are still editable.